audience member to places of imagination, to events that have emotions such as love, courage, anger, fear, but then also joy, peace. So it's going to be a really cool evening as we travel into the woods together into imagination. On stage before you is our fifth grade beginning band. These are first year students, and if you are, hopefully you're here for Christmas concert, and you're going to see a huge difference from now, from then till now. It's mind blowing. This is one of my favorite parts of my job, is to see the growth of these students. So, as you board this train, you are currently on a train to Mexico. And our first piece for you tonight is La Bamba, a Mexican folk song that evokes fun, vibrant color, and a sense of excitement.
Thank you.
Ensemble. And my pleasure tonight is to announce our most valuable player for the fifth grade band. This is kind of the criteria for getting this award, is someone who shows outstanding leadership in the classroom, passion, musical ability. And I'm really proud of this young man who has worked hard from day one. And he's just an outstanding player. I can't wait to watch him grow. So the spring most valuable player for fifth grade beginning band is Mr. Nathan Kirkland. And our second award is what I call the most improved player. And this is someone who I've kind of been keeping my eye on. Usually it's a student who at the beginning was struggling just a little bit, but then they're so passionate about learning their instrument that I can see the growth. And a lot of them, these are kids that come ask me, how can I get the lessons? What can I do? And so this is a young man, again, who has just shown outstanding passion for his trumpet playing. I'm pleased to announce that our fifth grade 2015 most improved player goes to Wilson Flynn. So we've just had a tour of the world. Now we're going deeper into the woods to a time where a land, the time forgot. And the apex predator of the Jurassic period was the mighty T-Rex. The sixth grade intermediate band on stage is going to transport you to a land full of uncertainty and mysterious things are going to be happening. So this is T-Rex. Christ teaches us in the scripture that things are going to happen to us, and We're going to go through trials and we're going to go through tribulations, but those are things that come our way to test our faith, to see how faithful we're going to be to our Lord. It always says that He's never going to give us anything that we can't handle. So amongst all the uncertainty and all this imagination that we're throwing at you as we dive deeper into the woods, is we're now going to play a song for you called All Upon Earth, which is a hymn tune that you will recognize as the doxology, because God is our peace. He's our joy. Amongst all of these different emotions and different things that are coming at us, God is our peace and our joy. And to Him we give praise. So this is All 100.
Thank you.
outstanding musician, outstanding leader in the classroom, and I'm really happy to award Hannah Arnold as our most valuable player for sixth grade intermediate band. But I do believe it's going to be great. Our most improved player, this is a young lady who, when I found out she's new this year to CCS, and when she originally approached me, she asked me if she could play violin, and I said, well, I would love for you to play violin, but right now that's just not going to work. And she goes, oh, that's okay, I'll just pick up something else. So that immediately showed me, hey, this is a young lady who's really going to be a leader in the classroom, and she's come a very long way, and she's, you know, just every day she just gets better. And I always told her, you know, she picked God's instrument. So she picked the trombone because that's what I play. That's what all the angels in heaven play, the trombone, not the trumpet. Okay. So I'm really proud to announce that our sixth grade most improved player is Miss Elle Hoyt.
Thank you.
culture of ancient Egypt. This piece that we're performing next as our final number for our seventh grade advanced band is called Egyptique. It's supposed to transport your mind to the time of Pharaoh. You're going to hear a lot of interesting harmonies, a lot of stuff that you're going to go, I don't know if that's right. In music, we call that dissonance. Music is so cool, the fact that we, you know, what makes this sound Indian, what makes this sound Egyptian, what makes this sound French, and all these different harmonic textures that come into play. And in our final number, we transport you to the time of Pharaoh in a piece called Egypt. join us. And there's a composer by the name of Eric Whitaker. He's really prominent in today's music library. He writes some really interesting things, both for choral pieces and band pieces. And this is originally a choral piece transcribed for band, based off Rudyard Kipling's, one of my favorite books by Rudyard Kipling, The Jungle Book. So we transport you now to the world of Rudyard Kipling inside The Jungle Book, where a mother seal is singing to her pup that everything would be all right. In a piece called The Seal Lullaby, which is going to feature pianist Mr. Tim Connor, who is back there. If you could give him a huge round of applause.
Once upon a time, in a far, far land, where a village lay upon a wood.
Thank you.
is one of those pieces of music where I tell you to hang on. It's going to evoke every emotion that you can think of. This is a piece of music that's based off the Nordic tale, the Norse people, their mythology, of an event in their culture called Ragnarok, which is kind of like the Battle of Armageddon. In this piece, you're going to be transported to a dark and barren world where things are not going very well. There's a huge battle, but then at the end, you're reminded, that's what I was trying to tell our students, reminded that even though all of this stuff that we're going through, the battles that are in our life, that God, the only God, Yahweh, will get us through that, because he says that he will never leave us nor forsake us. So we invite you to use your imagination as we transport ourselves to the land of the ancient Nordic people in a final piece of music for you called Fate of the Gods.
Thank you.
so glad you're here. We hope that myself and the students hope that we have transported you this evening to a world full of imagination, but also to the biblical truth that our God will never leave us. He's always there. He fights our battles for us. That we don't have an imaginary force. He's real. He has a living, breathing word. And we hope that we've gotten you through the woods to the other side, to the land that's flowing with milk and honey. Now, it's my privilege to announce our high school, 8th and 12th grade, most valuable player. This is a young lady who, when I was performing for the Oak Ridge Community Orchestra, I asked her to come, and it was really hard because it's legit classical music, Beethoven, Brahms, all these hard pieces of music, and she just jumped right in and transposed on her own, which is a very hard task to do. So it's my honor and privilege to announce that this semester's most valuable player is Brenna Flint. And our final award for the evening is the most improved player, which is another young lady who is one of those students who is actually now taking another instrument lesson. She's trying to get another instrument under her belt, and she's just a joy to have. She's always smiling. She always has a great sense of humor in class that I need. When I'm not having a good day, she's always there to make me smile. And she's just a really hard worker and definitely going to be a leader as she progresses through her high school next year. She's an eighth grader now, so she'll be a freshman in the fall, so I can't wait to see her growth. So this semester's most improved player goes to Elizabeth Farmer.
Didn't they? listening to some practice. Maybe for some people it hasn't been great at first, and also a lot of money to go into it too, with instruments and lessons. And it's great to see when all this pays off, when the kids come together and they sound marvelous together. So I'm really proud of all of you guys for what you've done. We do want to say thank you to Mr. Stevens, because we know we need a great leader. Thank you for coming, and we hope you'll join us for the refreshments.